You're on shared hosting right now and you need to change to a VPS. Why? Because you outgrown your shared hosting or your application that you're going to install needs some certain settings and root access to actually get it working. And that's why you want to jump into a VPS. Luckily, there's a system that's called KVME, which is a VPS, a virtualization system of a physical server that makes it really inexpensive to jump to a VPS. In this case, I'm going to show you the KVME plans from Hostinger so you can see what you're going to get and why it's a great jump to jump from shared hosting to a VPS. That's a KVME. So let's go jump over to my desktop right now. Okay, so I want to show you the great pricing that they have and why it's a good idea to jump into a VPS. So if you're on the Hostinger side, which I'll leave the link in the description, jump into hosting, go into VPS hosting, and you're going to be able to view these plans, which are KVME. They're really inexpensive. And why is this? Well, a KVME plan means that it's a virtualization from a physical server. So to keep things simple and in perspective, we're going to think about a physical server that has 100 CPU cores, 100 gigabytes of RAM, 100 terabytes of storage, etc. And they can divide this into multiple with the division of RAM, CPU, and storage. And they are dedicated for each one of us. And that's why they can make this really inexpensive. Now, thinking about these plans that they have available. For example, the most popular one, we get 2 CPU cores, 8 gigabytes of RAM, 100 gigabytes of NVMe disk space, and 2 terabytes of bandwidth. So we get these dedicated resources to us. That means that if we get this, that's what we're going to get. It's not going to be less or more, which would be the case of shared hosting. Now, shared hosting is a great option, and it's really super inexpensive, but it has its downsides and its plus sides. But one of those is that you are sharing the resources over there. In this case, you are not. This is what you get, and that's how it's going to stick. That way, it's not going to be a difference of site speed when someone is loading. Sometimes it's fast, sometimes it's slower, which would be the case on shared hosting and not on this, okay? Now, one of the cool things that you get on these plans is that you get a snapshot for this. Each one of these has a snapshot included. That is going to save your life in a certain stage. Why? Because that means that you can set a snapshot to, well, a snapshot is like you take a picture of whatever is inside of your VPS. That means that if you have 10 sites installed with certain customizations, etc., it's going to take a perfect snapshot of what's going on right now. So that means that if your site breaks or your whole server breaks, you have a perfect snapshot of everything in the server and you can just go ahead and restore it. That's a pretty cool option to have there. Weekly backups, a dedicated IP address. So again, not a shared IP. You have your own dedicated IP. That means that you take care of your IP and don't spam people, don't do weird things, don't install fake sites or spam sites, and your IP is going to be fine. With shared hosting, there's several people in a IP address. So that means if someone is messing up things, it's messing it up for everyone. Now, there's mechanisms for that to prevent that. But again, you have that kind of issues with shared hosting. Okay. Then there's the full root access. This is a must when you need to customize and install certain type of websites, SaaS, or applications that need full root access. You get this with a VPS. You don't get that with shared hosting. Okay. And all of that with this pricing, which is super inexpensive to be a VPS. Now, let's go ahead and select this one for testing purposes, which is $70.99 a month, but there's an extra discount coupon code that I want to show you. So in this case, you have two options. You can select 1 month, which is obviously not a good deal, but if you want to do some testing, you can go ahead and select that. But this is the best pricing for 12 months, and it renews at $10.99. Now, there's an extra discount. Like I mentioned, right now it's $95.88, but I have a coupon code. So if I use SaaS Master and apply it, we're going to see this drop down to $86.29, which is a great deal. That's paid for a year and you're good to go. And you have a VPS with root access with your dedicated resources. Okay. Now let's jump over to the VPS panel. So in this case, I have my VPS installed already on Hostinger and we're going to be able to see that we have our own IP address, which is this one right here. My status, it's running. And in this case, I installed the OS Ubuntu 22.04. with 64-bit with desktop. That means that this is where I'm going to take care of my VPS information. Now, when you have a VPS, you're going to need a VPS manager. And the VPS manager is where you're going to install your website, okay? Now, there's several VPS managers like CyberPanel, like OpenLightspeed, Server Avatar, and several more. Some are free, some are inexpensive, and some are really expensive. So you decide what you want to use. I use Server Avatar, which is really inexpensive, and it has all the needs that I need for a VPS manager. Now, for this, you're going to need your IP address and your password to install it in a server manager. In the settings, you have your password. In case you forgot your root password, you can reset it here. If you reset it, you need to update it in the VPS manager if you installed it previously, okay? If it's brand new, don't worry about it. So, next thing you have is the SSH access, panel access, the plan details for this one. You have your settings. You have your main settings for this. You can see reset firewall, the IP address, the emergency mode, the SSH keys. We can add a key right here. This is really useful for some type of connections. There's the operating system. So when you install your first KVM VPS, you're going to install an OS. In this case, I installed Ubuntu 22.04. But if you messed up, if you decided to change, you can do so here. You can use a OS with control panel. Like I mentioned before, this is an OS that has a panel that you can install websites. And there's the plain OS, which is what I installed, and you're going to need a VPS manager or the application, which is just installing one single website in a VPS. You won't be able to install multiple sites. Be aware that if you change your OS after installing websites and all that, they're going to be erased. So be aware of that. Do this before you go into the actual connection for the VPS panel and installation of websites. So it's a really great way to have a VPS without that expensive price tag that other VPS have or a dedicated server. But if you need something more powerful, you have the options on Hostinger. But if you need something inexpensive that's a VPS, the KVME are a great option. Check out these prices and test them out for yourself and decide if this is a route that you want to go. And especially if you're jumping from shared hosting, you definitely want to grab something like this, which is the next step. And you're going to be able to have a VPS with a great price. Well, that is KVME VPS from Hostinger, and that's a wrap.